Now, if you look at the current status of the, especially the manufacturing industry with which our company deals with, all the companies are in a state of flux where, they had been thinking about using of technology for improving the efficiency, but probably for some reason or the other, they have been avoiding it. Because maybe it was not essential. But now with this COVID pandemic striking, I think now it has become absolutely essential that they have to move towards the technology, because the inefficiencies in the organizations can perhaps totally derail the companies themselves. So for the benefit of our viewers, Prashant, can you tell us something about the different types of technology that are available, which can be used by the manufacturing industry for improving the efficiency?
Sure. So that's I think you certainly painted the right picture, Srinivas, and it goes without saying the kind of scenario that most businesses find themselves in. But I'm going to answer your question in a slightly different way. You asked me about what kind of technology or what technology components are available for manufacturing institutions or manufacturing companies. But let me answer that from the perspective of data. So if you want to, what does every industry want to do today? Every industry today wants to stay in business and grow, right? These are fundamental needs. And the challenge that people face today is that they get disrupted. Industries get disrupted due to natural pandemics like the one we're going through, or there are industry or ecosystem changes that literally drive companies out of business, which at the same time create new business models as well. So the challenge is, how do you make sure that you are one among those companies which sustain for years, for decades, and don't become a note in the history of business that yes, there used to be a company that was running successfully some time back and it doesn't exist today. So how do you prevent yourself from being in that kind of situation? And for that, the answer is not technology. The answer is data. Data is what will help you to overcome all these challenges that I talked about. So if you look at the way this data changed, right? If you look at olden days, you had manual books, and then you graduated to one computer in the business, and then now you're probably at a stage where everybody's got three computers with them. You got a tablet and a phone and a laptop, or so there's computing everywhere. It is literally ubiquitous, and it's woven so deeply into every aspect of our lives that it's impossible to separate it. So we went from no data to siloed data. And that's where I think most businesses are stuck today. And what do we mean by siloed data? Siloed data is data that's available in the company, in your business, but it's distributed in different places, and there is no connectivity between the data that you have in your organization. As a result, what happens is that you don't get actionable insights. What does a businessman want? A businessman wants to know the unknown. You want to know what you don't know. And the only thing that can help you, leaving aside astrology, the only thing that can help you know what you don't know is data. And you need to use data properly to uncover insights about your industry, about your customers, about the way your people are working, and about the changes that are happening across the world. That's what I mean by actionable insights. So there's data that's inside the company, and there's data that's outside the company. How do you merge both, and how do you get actionable insights? And when you get these actionable insights, you will drive real-time change. And that means your business is one of those which will sustain disruptions and which will sustain or cross situations such as the one that we're seeing today, and be a business that lasts decades and more. So that really is the answer I would say. And you might be wondering, I'm a technology guy, why haven't I said even one word of technology? Answer. Because if you look at technology over the time, it's changed, right? What this is a world where, unlike manufacturing, you say 30 years of experience in manufacturing is an asset. You would love to have someone who has 30 years of experience in manufacturing. But anything beyond 5 years of experience in IT largely becomes redundant because technology life cycle is so rapid. The technology maybe that was used 6 or 7 years back doesn't become relevant. But what is relevant really? What doesn't change? The fact that you have a business model at the heart of which is your customer, and surrounded by your customer are your business partners, your suppliers, your vendors, the other market forces. I think this fundamental thing in business has never changed. But today, what is really helping businesses sustain is data. And we can talk about technology components. We can talk about IoT, ML, AI, all the buzzwords that we want to do. But the way I would ask any business person to approach this transformation that they want to undergo is by looking at data. And to enable this data, that's where technology starts to come in. So if you're a manufacturing organization, you will have IoT, for instance, giving you real-time data from your machines or from your various components in your factory. You could have a cloud-based collaboration platform which will give you a better experience for your employees. You can connect to you. So there are n number of things that we can talk about. And today we're talking about maybe a few buzzwords. Those buzzwords could change down the line over the next 3 to 4 years. But the fact is, the data and the need to analyze your data and make sure that you are able to uncover insights which before others can see them, before a business can come and disrupt you, that really is a need of the hour. So what you're really doing here, just to summarize what I said, is to move from gut feel. I mean, entrepreneurs in the past used to survive and grow by gut feel. They had this instinct. Yeah, this is what I believe will work. This is what I believe should do. And there are entrepreneurs who thought or made the right assumptions, but situations did not support them, and therefore they did not succeed as much as they could. But today, you want to move away from gut feel decision making, or you want to move away from what I call hippo. Hippo, unlike the animal, is called the highest paid person's opinion. So you don't want to listen to someone who will give you gut feel. You want to actually apply those insights to data and have data-driven decisions. And that, I think, is what will help organizations to succeed.
Beautiful. I think you went to the core of what I was asking, because the efficiency in manufacturing organizations can be improved only by going to the micro level data. I think some of the companies that I've been working with, they started collecting data on the machines and the condition based maintenance, shifting from preventive maintenance to a condition based maintenance on the basis of data. Okay, so and I also heard several stories about how in agriculture the efficiency is being improved by going to the root of the functioning of the plant and so on, with a lot of data again as to when the plant requires nutrition, when the plant requires the water, and then give only as much as it is required based on data. So I think that's the, I would say, definitely the pinnacle of efficiency. And then you have put it very rightly, saying that companies have to shift from gut feeling to database management. Actually, the total quality management, which is being practiced by many manufacturing companies, recommends this, saying that work on the basis of the data and not just on the basis of the gut feel. Gut feel companies are the professionals may use on the shop floor, but that can't be the only tool that they use for improving the efficiency. So I think you said it very nicely, Prashant. I totally agree with that.